What's up everybody, welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. Nice to see you back, and today we will continue with our Bhagavad Gita series. And today I was asked a question recently which I will be answering. Who is a true friend? What is the definition of a friend? And how do we know that this person who is with us or who claims to be with us is our friend or not in reality? Alright, so if you were the one who had asked me that question, or if you want to know the answer, I will try my best to share what the Gita says and what I've learned from my gurus and the different traditions and different places that I've visited. Alright, so if you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website. The link is there in the description below somewhere. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will be there. And He will also help you find who are your true friends. Alright. So now, in scriptures, there are lots of definitions of this word friend, which we have in the English literature. And there are different definitions like bandhu, surid. Yes, and there is so many other. There are four categories of people actually who we associate with. And then there are different levels. Yes, suhrid is one who is very intimate with you, who is very close. Yes, there is mitra, there is bandhu. So, but I will not go into the terminologies of all those. For now, let us consider that friend is anybody who we like to talk to or who we like to associate with. Yes, so let's take the standard connotation for a friend. Now, those people are there, but the question is, what does the scripture say about friends? Yes. The scripture says, see, Lord Krishna says in the Gita, Suhridam sarva bhutanam gyatvam am shantim ruchati. Which means he says, Bhoktaram yagya tapasam sarva loka maheshwaram. Suhridam sarva bhutanam means, I am the greatest well-wishing friend of anybody and everybody. Yes, for all time to come. Gyatva mam shantim ruchati. Gyatva mam means when somebody knows this. Shantim ruchati. He obtains peace. Yes. And in the previous two lines of the shloka, he says, Bhoktaram yagya tapasam. I am the bhokta of all the yagyas and all the tapasyas. Sarva loka maheshwaram. I am the undisputed ruler of all the sarva loka. Sarva loka maheshwaram. Yes. I am the Ishwar of all the lokas. So basically what Lord Krishna is telling here, that one who understands me to be the controller, enjoyer and most well-wishing friend of everybody, yes, that person obtains peace. So now, that means anybody in this universe who helps us to know this fact, or who inspires us to go close to this fact, is actually our friend. Yes, because even in the Srimad Bhagavatam there is a shloka where it is said, Guru nasasyat, Pita nasasyat, Janani nasasyat, Devo nasasyat, na patimcha. Yes, it's a very long shloka which is there in the Bhagavatam. Basically, the essence of the shloka, it means that Guru nasasyat, Pita nasasyat, one has no right to be the guru or a teacher or a educator or a preceptor or a guide, basically, or a counselor. Guru nasasyat, pita nasasyat, one has no right to be the father. Devo nasasyat, to be a demigod. Na patimcha, a husband. Yes. Janani nasasyat, no right to be a mother. These are basically leadership positions which people have, yes. Some kind of authority is there on you. If you are a father or a mother, you have an authority over your children. So, Srimad Bhagavatam says, you have no right to become any of these unless you can deliver your subordinate from the cycle of birth and death. Yes. So, that means, whenever we are choosing our friends or our friend circle, we need to be very careful that we do not associate with those people who drag us down to lower habits. Yes. What are lower habits? The four pillars of sin which is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. What is that? The first one is no meat eating. Yes. So if we are planning to reduce the consumption of meat, we are planning to give up meat, that's best if you could do that. Because Scriptures say one who has not given life has no right to take life. Yes. So how would you feel if somebody would come and kill your son or daughter? You would not like that person, right? So if we go on killing animals, then God will not like that. Yes, because they are also his children. So let us try to give up meat completely if we are still indulging it, but slowly and gradually. We don't have to take a resolution that today I am eating, tomorrow I will not eat. Yes, slowly we can reduce. So that is about meat, and in that all the different things come. Yes, chicken, mutton, fish, and all these things, pork, beef, everything is included in that. All right. And then intoxication, that's the second principle. What is intoxication? Intoxication is basically all those tea, coffee, addiction to wine, alcohol, all those things come under that. Smoking, weeds, or I don't know, whatever is there. I don't have much experience in this domain. Then comes gambling, yes, betting somewhere, playing all those cards. Yes, that's horrible, because that sucks away our spiritual progress. Yes, it makes us very dull. Anybody who does gambling, you go and watch them, their minds are always with money, profit. Yes, how can I suck money out of this? So now, it's not bad to earn money, but it is not good to do gambling. And then the next is illicit sex. In that, premarital sex is considered, then extramarital, and then watching pornography, losing our semen, wasting our semen, basically. All those things come under illicit sex. So if there is anybody in our friend circle who is pulling us towards those four activities, then we have to eventually give up their association, because staying with them will also degrade us. Yes. So basically, if I know many people who are trying to give up meat, and then they tell me that, oh, but whenever I meet this friend, they always tell me, oh, you are wasting time not eating meat. Now you could enjoy. See, we are enjoying. Yes, because they say sins are like credit cards. Enjoy now and pay later. Should I repeat? Sins are like credit cards. Enjoy now and pay later. So they cannot see the higher purpose of why to leave eating meat. Yes. They only see the instantaneous, quick, near pleasure which they get, because they do not have spiritual inquisitiveness. So if we have people in our friend circle who are pulling us towards all these things, then we have to ensure that we give up their association, because every time we go and meet them, they will humiliate us, they will discourage us, they will degrade us. Yes, because they are themselves degraded, they will also ensure that we also remain degraded. Sometimes they behave like crabs. You see, in a big bucket you put 10 crabs, yes, and in that you try to lift one of the crabs, then what the other 9 crabs will do? They will pull him down. Him or her, maybe. Because they cannot tolerate that somebody goes above. Yes. So if somebody is doing all these things, nefarious activities, and they are also pulling us, yes, suppose they are saying, oh, today we are going to the pub, we'll drink there, we will party till 6 a.m. in the morning. Yes. We are going to get drunk, then in the night we will go with some girl, we will indulge in illicit sex, we will do this, we will do that. If this is the kind of people that we are having in our friend circle, then we have to give up their association. That is very important for our spiritual life. Yes. If somebody is drinking and smoking and they always keep pulling us, bye bye, aja aja, come, we will also try. Now, only once you smoke, nothing happens. No, it doesn't work like that. Once, it's for all. Ek bar kiya to hamesha karoge. Always remember this. So what to do if we have these people? So we have to distance ourselves from these people, all right? And then now the question is, if we distance ourselves from these people, who do we go and talk to? Who do we make friends? Yes. So the answer is very simple. You have to find within your friend circle who is in line with that shloka. Yes, Surida Sarva Bhutanam Gyatva Mam Shanti Mruchati. If you see that somebody in your friend circle is quite spiritual in nature, he or she has interest in higher inquisitiveness, in higher topics, then that person is fit to be your friend. Yes. Then that person can help you elevate your consciousness, because ultimately it is all that the only thing that matters is at the end of the day, are you going close towards God or not? If that is not happening and everything else is happening, well, you're losing the match. You are getting promotions, you are working in corporate, you are earning millions, or you are a billionaire in business or whatever it is. At the end of the day, if you are not going close to God, everything is simply a waste of time if that is not happening. Because at the end of your life, you will be stripped of everything. Yes, you came without wearing any clothes and you will go from this world without wearing any clothes. Yes, what to speak of clothes? My dear sir, my dear madam, ladies and gentlemen, even this body which we take care very well, putting lotions, putting creams, putting deodorants, yes, even that body is not going to stay with us. What to speak of clothes and what to speak of gold, what to speak of our beautiful wife or our handsome husband. Nothing's gonna stay. We are gonna go alone. The soul is going to go. Yes, so always, whenever you are choosing friends, always ensure that you choose the right people, because they say that you are the average of five people who you associate with. Okay, should I repeat? You are the average of five people who you associate with. If you are making friends with people who are gossiping, who are discussing about the private parts of the opposite sex, yes, 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 why not? Then those things get imprinted in your mind. Yes. Then what you do in the night, you go and watch pornography and you lose your semen. Yes, that is not good. That's very detrimental for our spiritual life. Yes. Or if they are unnecessarily gossiping. Yes. Suppose you meet some girl, she is gossiping. Oh, that girl is having an affair. That boy is having an affair. Throw that girl out of your life. Or if your best friend, he is doing like this, just throw him out of your life. Yes, I am using very strong words here. We cannot afford to maintain the company of those people who will degrade our consciousness. We cannot do that. We have to make a decision, either this or that. Yes, so that is how you decide whom to associate with. Yes, and now somebody may say, oh, in my company, in my college, there is nobody like this. I'm very unfortunate. Then what I have to do? Well, then what you do is you find some spiritual circles, yes, some centers near the college or place where you are staying. I'm definitely sure you will find somebody, some satsang program, some religious program. There you can go and make friends there. Yes. And now regarding the company or the school or the college where you are staying, what you can do is you can associate with some people who do not indulge in sinful habits, but their nature is a bit good. They may not necessarily be spiritual, okay, but at least they do not indulge in unnecessary sinful habits. So for the time being, the 6 hours, 8 hours when you are in the company, you can associate with them, all right? And then in the weekends or in the evening, you can go and associate with the people about whom I mentioned. That you can go, if you have some spiritual center, some community nearby, go and ask the leader there, go and ask the authority, whoever is in charge of that place, that my dear sir, I am working in this company, do you know somebody who also comes to this program, to this meditation or this yoga session? Because I want to make friendship with that person. Yes, although these things are very difficult, but I've realized in my course of the spiritual journey which I have had, that if you have sincere desire, God will reciprocate. Should I repeat? If you have sincere desire, God will reciprocate. Which means, if we want to cultivate our life with the right people, right means spiritual, all right, then we need to pray to God, and then God will bestow us with that benediction. Yes, God does it. I have seen. He has done it in my case. Why will He not do it for you? All right, so that will happen. We don't have to worry much regarding that. The only thing we need to do is we have to have sincere desire. Yes, because Lord Krishna also says in the Gita, I reciprocate as they desire. Yes, which means that if you desire to have company of people who are discussing about the opposite sex or about Game of Thrones or about Big Boss or about movies, things which will actually do no good to your life, but instead they will degrade you, they will take your consciousness down, then you will end up meeting such people in your life. There will be plenty of those people. But if you desire to have spiritual company in your friend circle, then God will bless you with spiritual circles. Yes, He will bless you. He will abundantly bless you, like He has blessed so many, me and some of many of my God brothers I know. Abundantly blessed. So, we can be blessed. Yes. We may not get the husband or wife of our dreams, but we may not get $1 million job. We may not get a Rolls Royce Phantom, but if we pray, this thing will definitely happen. Yes. So pray to God sincerely that please give me the association of people who also want to go close to you so that I can also stay close to them. Yes, and then from nowhere, from out of the blue, somebody will appear. Yes. So always remember this, have faith in God, and then pray to God and abstain from people who pull you down into nefarious activities. And then cultivate spiritual wisdom, read the Gita, the Bhagavatam in the morning, or the Quran or the Bible, whichever tradition you are. And then in the weekends, try to go and associate in the satsang programs which you are having, some yoga class, some meditation. Yoga, I mean not the physical, but different yoga systems are there. Yes, bhakti yoga is there. Then so many yoga systems are there. Some centers you will definitely find in your town or your city, or even in your village, maybe, if you have desire. Yes, God will arrange that. So have sincere desire and do all these things in the weekend. Maintain a good lifestyle. By that, you will understand whom to select as your friend and whom not to select. Okay. So that is it from my side. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please approach me to my website. The link is there in the description below. And that's all. And before I end, I will again say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will be there, and He will help you also to find the right people. Okay? Until next time, wish you good luck. Bye-bye.